Hello and welcome to my video of today. It's about CaseWise and the core tool called Corporate Modeler Suite, which you can see on the right hand side. It's a process modeling suite that contains multiple software components. The component I would like to focus is Corporate Publisher. It's a really amazing tool that allows you to take information from a database and publish or generate HTML Word output so you can communicate the content to different stakeholders. I'm not covering today the standard functionality, I'm more going into more depth into the enhanced functionalities. And this is called Corporate Publisher Scripting. I hope you will enjoy the following presentation and I will see you afterwards.
Hello, we will start this presentation with a brief PowerPoint and afterwards with a live product presentation. We will cover what is Corporate Publisher, how can we improve the output that Corporate Publisher produces, like adding breadcrumbs, search functionality, using a tab view to structure the content, link your model data to live content, or add feedback form. So this helps you to improve the usability. And then we cover how the Corporate Publisher scripting can help you to achieve this, and at the end we look at the benefits of having an attractive HTML publication. So what is Corporate Publisher? Corporate Publisher is a tool from CaseWise. It's the core tool since over 20 years, and the Corporate Modeler Suite contains multiple software components, and one component is Corporate Publisher. He can produce Word output and HTML outputs. And you can see you have table of contents, main pages, you have textual content with hyperlinks where you can navigate across different object types, and of course you have also diagrams to display in Word. It's similar in the HTML publication, but it's more interactive. You can navigate, you can drill down easily. You can also, of course, see the diagrams, you can zoom in, zoom out, you can really navigate all between the properties, you can read the properties, and you can also, of course, navigate across all different diagram types. So these are the two main types, the Word and the HTML output. In this presentation, I will cover the HTML output. So how can we improve now this output? First of all, Corporate Publisher has a functionality that allows the publication designer to inject external code into the final HTML page. This functionality is called CP scripting. You can add your own code, usually JavaScript or HTML codes, in the header, body and footer section. CP scripting allows us to add unbelievable functionality to our HTML publication, like menu bars, search functionality, breadcrumb navigation, tabs for better structuring your content, or using Google technology to enrich your graphical representation, like Google Charts, Google Maps. How does an improved HTML output look like? So you see on the left-hand side you have some navigation bar or the search menu. On top you have the breadcrumb and some other navigational controls. In the center of the window you have the tabs. The tabs allows you to structure your content in more easy way, so it's more intuitive. Then you can enrich your graphical representation, here an example of Google Map. You can also see the navigation color on the left-hand side is green, and it's a real-life map where you can navigate. Another alternative is the feedback form. You can see the feedback form is blue for the organization unit, and again you can simply submit your feedback. The next example shows the application and how we can use dashboards in order to visualize graphical or tabular content. So let's go to the product presentation. I'll show you this in the live HTML publication. So here you can see different tabs. I've added some tabs for YouTube video collection, and here you can see all my other videos as well. So it's easy accessible as part of this poldered publication. The top level diagram, you can see the different poldered objects, which are process, organization, location, data, application, technology. And behind these boxes, you have then, in this case, for example, the process flow, process order. You have different processes like check credit. And important, you can press the edit button. And if you have the CaseWise portal installed, including the web modeler, you can actually edit the diagrams immediately out of the static HTML page. You can see web modeler loads, it's a hosted solution. And here on the left-hand side, you can see the different object types that you can drag and drop. You can also obviously change the existing object simply by moving them around. But let's close this web modeler and go back to the HTML. You can also drill down from one high-level diagram to a low-level diagram. In this case, we have a workflow. That means you can also start a workflow. You can execute the process, actually. For this, you need Internet Explorer, and you have a web form where you can actually initiate your credit check request. So let's go back to the publication again. We now go into the process itself. The process as a property, like the record order. We can see a description. The process has also cross references to other poll.objects objects. We have a version control, of course, and already mentioned the feedback form that you can easily submit. But important here, you can also edit this existing instance of record order. You can select existing categories, and you can save or, of course, cancel input. We can also create new objects. In this case, we create a new process, and after we press the save button, it's actually saved in the central repository, and every other user can use this information. Obviously, in HTML, you need to run another generation of HTML publication or to see this here. Another example for active content is the location. We click on the UK head office, and we can see, as in the other object, we have an overview, which is the description, we have cross references, and the location map is the Google map, pretty much an interactive map. You can zoom in, zoom out, you can navigate around, you can change the map from satellite to hybrid map. So it's all embedded within this little tab here. The last example here is the application. So if we go, for example, to fleet management, again, we have a description, the cross references, and the system information we have used in the Google dashboard with bar chart and also displaying here a system uptime. So how can corporate publisher scripting help us in achieving this? And this is an example of the global HTML setting, and you pretty much use the CP scripting for linking an external document. And you can see this external document here, it's called tabs head, and it pretty much contains a lot of JavaScript information that should be injected into the header of the HTML publication. Below you can see the source code of the generated HTML publication. That means all you need to do, add the global HTML settings in Corporate Publisher, link to the text where you have the JavaScript described, and the final output has this publication. So let's go to the benefits of an attractive publication. So first of all, it's if the publication is visually appealing, the end user will use it more often and their resistance is less. The whole organization can identify themselves better with a corporate branded publication. The graphical visualization of textual tabular content makes understanding of content easier and more intuitive. A static HTML publication can be linked to dynamic web portal solutions like the Casewise portal, Google Maps, charts, or even SQL reporting services. This integration makes it a central component of your enterprise.
Hello, it's me again. I hope you found this presentation informative, and I also hope that you use this corporate publisher functionality in your own output. What you have seen are just a few random examples of what can be done with corporate publisher scripting, but I'm pretty sure you find your own examples and your own interactive way to enrich your static HTML publication. So, thanks for your attention very much. Any feedback is more than welcome, and I hope I see you in the next video. Bye.